Noise. Sometimes you just can't get rid of it. For those situations, you need to build your own Faraday cage. It's easy to make. You just need some metal screen mesh, some wood strips, an alligator clip cable, and some basic tools you can find at any hardware store. A roll of metal screen mesh is about $10 to $20, and you'll have so much you can make as many Faraday cages as you want. To begin, measure out a 8 by 16 inch rectangle on the metal mesh, and cut out this rectangle with some heavy-duty scissors. Now you want to measure 5 8-inch lengths of your wood strips. I'm using 3/8 by 3/16 wood, but you can use whatever you like. Then, carefully unroll your metal mesh so that it lays flat. Now, taking your light-duty staples and your favorite little handy staple gun, you are going to staple the wood strips through the metal mesh. Take the first wood strip and apply it to the end. Be careful about your fingers. Staple the next wood strip about 5.5 inches distant. Third wood strip about 2.5 inches distant. The fourth wood strip about another 5.5 inches distant. And the fifth wood strip at the end of the mesh. Now, as you can probably tell, we're using the wood strips as braces, and now that you've stapled them all, you can now shape the metal mesh into a small little box, your Faraday cage. What's nice about this is that it opens and closes easily, and you have ports on either side of the Faraday cage with which to manipulate your preparation for your experiments. To show it working, take your standard cockroach prep. Now here I've intentionally created a very noisy environment. I have my laptop hooked up to the wall outlet, I have my soldering iron on and the fluorescent lights on, and watch what happens when I turn on the spiker box. Too noisy for experiments, what can we do? Now take your alligator clip cable and clip it to the ground shield on the electrode connector. You can see this by looking at the spiker box on the side. Now place your spiker box into your Faraday cage. And clip the other end of the alligator cable to the screen mesh. You have much better signal quality. See those nice responses. Now there is an interesting physics reason for why the Faraday cage works at all. Ask your teacher about it. Backyard brains, neuroscience for everyone.